If you've watched sports as long as I have, and that's a long time, you know our next guest, Lesley Visser. She's covered just about every major sporting event in her award-winning career. She's been all over the world. She's the first woman to report from a Super Bowl sideline and hand over a Super Bowl trophy presentation, the Lombardi Trophy. She did it when my beloved Redskins won in Minneapolis. What was that, 1991-ish?
92.
First and only woman enshrined in the Pro Football Hall of Fame. Maybe you were watching the game last night from Canton, and the first female NFL analyst on TV for CBS Sports. Lesley Visser is still with CBS. She's also out with a new book on how she succeeded in the male-dominated sports broadcasting business. There it is. And there is a quote from Lesley Moonves, the trailblazer for women in sports journalism, blessed with both knowledge and heart. Enjoy this romp through her 40 years of covering sports.
And the book is called Sometimes You Have to Cross When It Says Don't Walk.
And that was advice from your mother?
It was. Thanks for asking. It was, by the way, before we start, I gobble you guys up, but I have to tell you, I almost always take your advice, except remember the time you projected that Kate Upton would marry Rupert Murdoch?
Did we do that?
You kind of missed on that. Would you say you kind of missed on that?
I think Justin Verlander,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, she did. She married a guy who won the World Series last year with the Houston Astros. Yeah.
You know, I saw them on a plane once.
Oh, yeah?
I know who you're talking about.
Yeah.
This was advice from your mom.
It was. We were living in Cincinnati. My family moved a lot as a kid, which was great for sports, not so good for a marriage, but great for sports. And when I was 10 years old, now this is in the 60s, early mid-60s, and women at that time were really four things: nurses, teachers, homemakers.
Secretaries.
Or secretaries, exactly. And my mom said to me, "What do you want to do when you grow up?" I was 10 years old. And I said, "You know what? I want to be a sports writer." You know, which was like saying, "I want to go to the moon," right? Didn't exist. And instead of saying, "Oh, forget that," my mom, you know how we're all parents who change somebody's in one sentence. My mom said to me, "That's great. Sometimes you have to cross when it says don't walk."
So, shall I ask the Moonves question?
Or do you want to ask the Moonves question?
I'm happy to ask the Moonves
question. I was hoping I could go on and on.
I'll ask one and then you'll ask another. You know him. You have worked at the network that he has helmed for a long time. What do you think of the allegations that have come up about him? How would you describe him to our viewers, and how do you think the company has handled it? And specifically, how has it handled it with respect to women who still work at CBS as you do?
Oh, that's all a great...
It's a lot.
It's a great question. No, it's...
I want to ask everyone that right. Michelle...
Yeah.
Michelle
has one still.
Okay. I'll try to unpack it. I think in no way do I want to disparage or demean those women who are brave enough to come forward, because that does take courage. But that was not my experience with Les Moonves, and I have just my own truth about it.
So he never hit on you?
Never. I've known him for 30 years from when I was already at CBS. He was at Warner Brothers. I've worked for him for 25, and my truth is just different from other women, and Les has a record of promoting and supporting women. Joanne Ross runs our sales. Lesley Ann Wade was our head of vice president of communications for 15 years. You all know Nancy Tellum ran entertainment. So some of us have a different truth, a different experience, which is not to diminish their word.
Does the fact that the board did not ask for him to go on a leave of absence, nor did they suspend him, unlike what the Ohio State board did with Urban Meyer in a different set of circumstances, what is the message that sends to women who work at CBS right now?
I think all of us, you know, as journalists, you don't want to rush to judgment. Mm-hmm. And I think all of us are waiting for all the facts to come in. As you know, CBS hired independent counsel. And I think everyone should wait for the investigation, which is not to diminish the bravery of those women. But I do wish somebody on the earnings call had asked, you know, as journalists, all of us, you kind of wish someone had asked him, but
right, but the analysts are very different than journalists.
Yes, they're different creatures.
Discovered.
Oh,
yes,
thank you.
Yes.
I did not know that.
Yeah, no, they tread more carefully than we do. So here you are, surveying this whole situation where women have made so many advances in the world. Is there still advice to be given out to young women out there who want to be what you are?
Oh, thank you for that. Absolutely, with regard to Les and CBS, everybody wants a safe workplace. Everyone deserves to be safe in the workplace. And whatever the investigation shows, it will see the results. But in the meantime, I just personally have never experienced either professional, economic, or sexual harassment from Les Moonves.
Have you experienced it from other people as you came up? You came up in a male-dominated field.
If you tell me no, I will not believe you.
And I will not tell you no.
Okay,
I was
good.
Really, why are you such a good journalist? I would say the four men, my career was shaped by four men because I was always the first woman, and I was blessed that none of them, Vince Story at the Boston Globe and the other three at CBS, Ted Shaker, Sean McManus, and Les Moonves. But that is
Ted
not.
Ted Shaker used to work here?
Oh, yeah, of course.
Oh,
we
yeah.
love
He's great.
We love Ted.
Yeah.
Ted sent me the fall of the Berlin Wall. I mean, I've had great experiences, but that's not to say many players along the way, coaches along the way. I mean, I have some scar tissue.
Who helped you more in your career, men or women?
Well, I was always hired by men, so those four, really.
Yeah.
Vince Story was my editor at the Boston Globe. Then I came to CBS under Ted, and then Sean and Les. So. I've sort of had to be the mentor to other women because there were no women. There were no ladies' rooms when I started. Imagine that, Michelle.
Yeah, no, it's when I first started the New York Stock Exchange, it was very hard to find a bathroom for women.
Isn't that insane?
Yeah, no,
I used to have to time it. Can I get down the press box and across the field?
Wow.
And the Patriots were terrible then. So, you know, I used to say they had the ball first and 10 on their own 20. And can I get back up there before they punt? And they were not that great, yeah. right? So I was like Usain Bolt.
when you read this book, it seems like there's nobody you haven't met. I mean, you have met practically everybody in sports, everybody in sports broadcast. You've been around the world. Let's talk a little bit about the NFL right now and its overall health. That is where you grew up, basically. Mm-hmm. There are a couple of things. Ratings are down. There is the controversy over the national anthem. Do you think the league has handled it well? And how do you look at the health of that league right now?
Oh, yeah, those are great questions. In terms of the ratings decline, you have to put that in perspective, that two elements there. One, you saw, I'm sure you knew David Tepper. He just paid $2.3 billion for the Carolina Panthers. Terry Pegula in Buffalo just paid $1.3 billion. Now, these are not major markets, not your kind of markets, but the television markets. So, I mean, that shows some health of the value of a franchise. Also, the ratings, while they have declined a little bit, the combined ratings for the NFL are larger than Major League Baseball, the NBA, and the NHL combined.
Okay.
So, you know, on balance, it's a healthy industry. As for the anthem, they should have resolved it by now. And just because no one knelt last night does not mean it's a good sign that the players and the league are talking. But
mm-hmm.
as somebody who is a native Bostonian. I grew up with Henry David Thoreau, and I believe in civil disobedience. I mean, peaceful demonstrations have been going on in this country for 200 years, and I think if they want to peacefully protest, I believe they should be allowed to.